Good morning, this is FloorDaily.net, and I'm Kemp Harr. I'm at the NWFA show in Orlando, and I'm with Michael Martin, the president and CEO. Michael, how you doing?
I'm good. How are you, Kemp?
I'm good. It's good to be with you. What's your read on the show? Are you pleased with it so far?
Absolutely. We've planned this meeting three times before we could actually have it. You know, we really couldn't plan this meeting until kind of toward the last minute because the COVID regulations kept changing every week. So we didn't know if we needed masks, didn't know if we could be 6 feet apart or if we had, you know, how we had to space the floor out. So those have been all challenges logistically, but we haven't really had any challenge with getting people here. People are excited to be here. They're excited to see each other again after 18 months of not seeing each other. It's so far so good.
How would this compare to a normal NWFA show as far as attendance and square area of exhibits?
So our show floor is about 50% of what it normally is, which falls in line with what we've seen with some of the other industry shows as well. And then our attendance is about 60% of what we normally have. So we're pretty pleased with that. In the meetings industry overall, we know some benchmarks. You know, heading into July, numbers were typically 30 to 40% of the show floor, 30 to 40% of the attendance. So we know we're doing better than some of the averages that are out there. And to be honest with you, the show floor is packed, so it doesn't really matter how many people are there as long as there's a great crowd and they're interacting and having a good time.
Well, I think you're doing better than the industry if those numbers are what they are. I mean, 60%, your co-located partner that's here is not quite 50% in you know, attendance or square area. I think you're doing well. Let's talk about that. You're here with coverings, and I'm getting some positive feedback about it. It's kind of neat that you're here co-located. The advantage is the downstream channel gets to come and see, you know, two different shows at one place. What's your take on it?
Yeah, you know, I think what's been great for us is that co-locating with coverings gave us the opportunity to expand our show hours where we knew we would have enough traffic to support longer hours for our exhibitors. So they're actually getting more hours on the floor show than they normally would because we really try to keep the show floor not competing against education. And so the way we handled this year was to put our education on the show floor. So we have two demo stages and two education sessions going on during the show. And then we have a crosswalk that goes over to the covering show. So if you are registered for our show, you can go over and see coverings, and if you're registered for coverings, you can come in and see the wood flooring side. So when you look at the marketplace, and most companies or retailers, if you're looking at retailers specifically, might be selling 10% of their product might be wood, so they might not ever come to the wood flooring show. But if 40% of their product is tile, and they're coming to the tile show, they'll definitely come over and see wood while they're here. So we're seeing that happen, and we're seeing a lot of cross-pollinization.
You think this could happen again?
I think it's important to recognize, I guess, from an event management standpoint, that every contract that everyone had has been blown up. It's a matter of renegotiating everything based on who we are now versus who we were when we booked the contracts. And, you know, we've got two cities that we had contracts with that we will probably want to look at again. We're going to be in Tampa next year, so, you know, definitely Tampa is where we'll be next year. When we go further than that, we have some open dates, and it's possible we'll look at a large variety of different opportunities.
All right, that's good. So let's talk about the hardwood flooring business. Mm-hmm. That's your area of focus. And I think one of your roles is to, you know, try to minimize the deselection of that. Talk about how the business is doing this year.
When you talk to the people that are here at the show, I have not yet found anyone who hasn't had the best year ever in 2020. And, you know, we certainly didn't see that going into 2020, but so especially given the fact that most people had 9 months out of the year to pack in a full best year ever, coming into 2021, everybody's very positive and upbeat and really excited about the product category. I would say a little bit of a resurgence in the interest of wood. People have been home in their homes for so long that if they spent more than 4 hours looking at the same thing they didn't like, they were ready to make a change, and there seems to be a natural tendency back toward natural product.
My next question is about the, you know, share take situation. We have watched some wood look-alike products take some share from wood, and a lot of those are imported. Do you think that this year you've been able to take some of that back?
Well, I think for sure, certainly we've seen in the marketplace, you know, the inability to get imports in, the inability to get things across the country in trucks. I think that has definitely helped the domestic producers. So I think the U.S. makers have certainly had an advantage there just being able to get material to people on time.
I walked your show today, and like you say, almost everybody, you know, say Don Finkel at American OEM, he basically told me, I'm only limited by my capacity. He said, you know, if I could make more, I could sell more. So I'm hearing that from several folks.
Absolutely. And I mean, if there's anything that is the theme of this year, it's really the word shortage. There's a shortage of labor. There's a shortage of product. There's a shortage of people to be in the plant. A lot of that's based on perhaps the stimulus dollars that are still out there, not getting people back to work. So hopefully we'll see some of that kind of pair off and come back to normalcy toward fall. But the lumber prices are, they're double what they were at least. It's a tough market, but it's also a really great market for most people.
So you had a meeting last night and you gave out some awards, and one of the awards went to Tommy Maxwell. He won the Hall of Fame Award and he almost got choked up. It's well deserved, right?
Absolutely. You know, Tommy Maxwell's been an integral part of NWFA since its beginning. He's been around since the first or second show. I think he was at the first show, so 35 years he's been with us, and he was instrumental in merging the NAFMA Association, which was the oak flooring manufacturers, into NWFA about 10 years ago. He's been on our board for 10 years, and he established a legacy scholarship program. He basically started that in honor of Bob Haggard, who was a manufacturer like Tommy in the NAFMA program. They'd known each other for years. Their families knew each other, and Bob passed way too early. And so Tommy wanted to do something to honor him, and so he started the Legacy Scholarship Program with that one scholarship, and he has been leading that charge, and we have 30 now people who have been into that Legacy Scholarship Program.
I know as a trade association, it's kind of rough to go through a situation like a pandemic. Have you been able to hold on to your staff, and are you working on some new initiatives that will help grow the hardwood business?
Definitely the pandemic has been a challenge for us as an association. You know, when your whole business is the job of bringing people together and you're forced where you can't bring people together, it makes revenues a challenge. But we've seen a lot of uptick on the marketing side with our advertising products, with our partners, and our education is back full swing. We went back in January. We've seen sold out classes and our products are doing well. The show is doing well. You know, I think considering the pandemic, we couldn't ask for anything better than what we're experiencing this week. And just to have everybody back together in a positive aspect is great. But we did use the downtime where we weren't able to travel and we weren't able to go out and hold training to kind of look at our own business and figure out some of the things we needed to focus on moving forward. And coming out of COVID, you know, certainly we have a definite opportunity to work on the installation labor crisis. There's certainly a problem there. I think if you talk to anybody on the show floor today, they'd tell you that they're only limited by the number of employees they have. If they had more, they would definitely be hiring. If they could, they'd be hiring more, and they'd have more business.
Your keynote speaker last night from the NAHB, he was fully charged with some of the issues that he's got with the incentives that have been given to keep people from working, right? I mean, he was adamant about that.
Absolutely, and I think if you talk to anyone in a rural area who's running a mill, they will tell you the same thing. Unfortunately, what I'm hearing out there is, you know, the first thing you do in the morning if you're running a mill is seeing how many people showed up so you can figure out what you can do that day. That's abnormal, and that's not a way that you can really focus on growth and capacity when you don't have a stable set of people showing up every day.
Another thing that came out of last night's meeting is a relationship with Real American Hardwood. Talk about that.
Kemp, as you know, we started a consumer-facing campaign a couple of years ago called the Real Wood, Real Life campaign. We put that out as a way to have all of wood kind of represented. You know, there, we couldn't go completely hardwood because there are some softwoods, pine, for example, that is used as a flooring product. So we went with Real Wood, Real Life. But we are part of 23 associations that make up the Hardwood Federation, which is our lobbying and advocacy arm in Washington, D.C. And those 23 organizations have come together over the last couple of years to work on an American hardwood promotion. We couldn't come out and say American because a lot of our distributors carry other products, but we can certainly be a part of their promotion that certainly is focused on the American hardwood and the value proposition of that.
Is that a consumer push about awareness of using hardwood?
Yes. It's all hardwood products, whereas, you know, we're just promoting wood flooring. They're promoting all hardwoods. We know by the market research that we've done and the consumer research we've done, if you say the word hardwood to a consumer, they naturally think flooring. So we know that by partnering with anyone who's marketing hardwood, that it will be good for wood floors.
All right, Michael, it's great to spend time with you. Thanks for spending time with our audience. Again, been talking to Michael Martin here at his NWFA show in Orlando, and you've been listening to Kemp Harr and FloridaLA.net.